Part 20, The Harlot of Babylon. The important thing to remember here is that in prophecy, a woman represents a church. A pure woman is a true church. An impure woman is a fallen church. That is what the harlot of Revelation 17 and 18 symbolizes, the most powerful apostate Christian church this world has ever seen. And where should we look to find this church? Revelation 17:9 says that the harlot sits upon the seven mountains. It's Rome. That has been known as the city of seven hills from classical times down to today. Listen to the description of this harlot. She's dressed in brazen purple and scarlet, decked with jewels of great value, and she holds a golden cup full of abominations of her false doctrines. And she's drunken with the blood of the saints, with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus. Again, Rome. Ever since the days of Babel, the city of Babylon has represented organized opposition to the purposes of God on earth. And the Bible carries the stern warning for all of God's people to come out of her. Don't partake of her sins that reach heaven. Don't receive the plagues that are coming to her. Remember this, if 1,000 years is a day to the Lord, the Inquisition, etc., took place only yesterday in God's eyes. Verse 17, verse 5, calls this woman the mother of harlots. The Church of Rome has claimed to be the mother church of all her strayed children, the Protestants who protested and left her in the 1700s. Chapter 17 goes on to say that 10 kings representing earthly governments will give their support to the papacy, but finally their eyes are opened and they turn on her and destroy her. God issues a fervent plea for his other sheep to come out of Babylon before the last days arrive. There are good Christians within the Roman Church, but they must leave her if they wish to avoid God's wrath, which is the seven last plagues. Beware, says the Bible. Babylon is fallen and has become the habitation of devils. The Church of Rome is a fallen spiritual Babylon.